Hi, I'm Deborah, and I'm a researcher at UCSD, and the purposes of these videos are to demystify lab techniques, specifically what it's like to set up and run an experiment that studies circadian rhythms. So in this video, I'm going to walk through how to set up an experiment that looks at wheel running behavior in rodents to learn more about their circadian rhythms. It is important to note that before we run an experiment, we have to have our protocol approved by IOCUC, which is the Institutional Animal Care and Use Committee, and this committee reviews our protocol and approves things that have to do with animal care and use, especially how our experiment will be run and how we'll take care of the animals while we're doing it. The protocol needs to be approved every 3 years. We house our mice in the vivarium where we expose them to a 12-12 LD cycle. That means the lights are on for 12 hours and then off for 12 hours. We use Black 6 mice that we purchased from Jackson Laboratories and breed in the lab to ensure genetic homogeneity. And that genetic homogeneity becomes important to minimize any variations between animal behavior. So now I'll set up a cage that we would typically use for our experiments. So we have our base here. It's a plastic cage with corncob bedding in the bottom. And we have a setup here that we've actually cut the bottom off of a cage and mounted a wheel, just a wheel from a pet store on it, with two magnets 180 degrees apart. So there are setups that are commercially available, but we make our own to keep costs a little lower. So that sits right inside here. And the magnets become important for the sensor, which sits on this metal insert. It sits right on top of where the magnets pass, and that helps the sensor actually detect each time the magnet passes by, and that's how we log the activity of the animal in the cage. And the metal insert also holds the food and the water for the animal. So after we set up the cages, we select mice for our experiments. Typically, we select about 12 to 16 mice per group. This time, we'll use 12. And the age of the animal can be very important. Typically, we try to use animals that are about 12 weeks. We have used older, we have used younger, but on average, we like to keep it around 12 weeks because that tends to be the best age to use them. So then we just put them right in there. Okay. So now we're ready to put them in our chamber. Each chamber is light tight and kept at room temperature, which is between 70 to 72 degrees. So each chamber's light supplies is hooked up to these timers, which can hold a bunch of different programs. And this controls when the lights go on and off in one chamber so that all animals in that chamber are exposed to the same lighting conditions. So we set the time, and then we set the time that we want the lights to go on and the time that we want the lights to go off. And it's really important that we keep each chamber labeled with the lighting schedule so that other lab members and the animal care technicians know when they can and can't enter the chamber. So it's really important that the chamber stays closed when the lights are off because any inadvertent light can skew the experiment results. So inside, you'll even see we have a chamber here. We usually keep four chambers on each shelf. There's one animal per cage, and we have them plugged into these devices here. And each time the wheel spins and the sensor detects activity, this light will blip. So we make sure to keep all of these covered up with electrical tape because even that small amount of light can skew our results. So it's really important that we keep the lights dark, that we keep the lights off when they need to be off. And we use this weather stripping here to make sure that absolutely no light can get into the chamber.